Well, let's go to economic issues, because we have this industrial action plaguing our ports. It's huge. It'll hit consumers on the cost of goods they get when they eventually are moved by the stevedores into our shops and off the boats. The PM's refusing to step in and help sort out the issues. He's indeed even taken a swipe at the port operators, DP World. He said it's a Dubai-based company that's, quote, made considerable profits. But I might remind viewers, Nick Cater, these are workers who earn, on average, $130,000 a year. Now, I don't begrudge them being paid good money, but their union is demanding a further 16% wage hike, again, which means all those costs get passed on to us. You can see why the company says we want to talk about it.
Well, exactly. There have to be signs of genuine increases in productivity to justify any pay rise. And as you say, they are very well paid, very well remunerated, and very good conditions under which they work. This idea that DP World somehow makes too much profit, I mean, and it just goes to show the Prime Minister is just has no idea about business and investment. If they weren't making a profit, they would not invest in this country, and they wouldn't bring their expertise and their port handling skills and machinery to this country, which in the end help make imports and exports cheaper. And that's vital for a country like ours, that we have free-flowing ports, that the stories we hear now of containers piled up on the docks waiting to be moved, that is really bad for the economy, and it's bad for inflation. And the Prime Minister just seems to be out of touch with what business needs to keep those ports running.
And I also might add, it's our exports going out as much as it is the imports coming in. I'll talk to the Farmers Federation about that point tomorrow. A lot of stuff spoiling on docks because it can't exit the ports. Hey, Caroline, what's this story in New South Wales? Some talk that jury deliberations are going to be time limited. I read this morning, and as a lawyer, that's a huge red flag to me. What's it about?
Well, as it turns out, here in New South Wales, juries have a minimum amount of time in which they have to reach a verdict without where it can be like a majority verdict. So in other words, it's a bit complicated, but in other words, in New South Wales currently, they jury must have deliberate for a minimum of 8 hours. And if they can't reach a unanimous verdict, then an 11-1 verdict would be accepted. Now there are calls to change the law so that this minimum period is reduced in half to 4 hours. In other words, they'd only have to deliberate for 4 hours, and if they can't unanimously agree, a court would accept that majority verdict in that case. Now, there are lawyers who are saying that this would not be fair in the process, that it would lead to pressure on jurors to make decisions. It would be disastrous for the legal system. But it is also worth pointing out that in other states across the country, these minimum periods are actually much lower. And that's not to say that that should be the case, but New South Wales is already one of the strictest. For example, in Victoria, they don't even have a minimum period. They just have to deliberate for a reasonable amount of time, which is obviously incredibly subjective. And in other states, it's as little as 2 or 4 hours that they have to deliberate. So there's a really inconsistent period across the board when it comes to jury deliberations.
Yeah, as I said, it's a real worry to me. Nick Cater, Caroline Marcus, thank you both for your time.